Now then, my guests on the show today are seasoned professionals in the world of acting and performing, having notched up, well, about 30 years of performing over the years on the big and the small screen. Listen, what an absolute pleasure to welcome to Wave 102. It's only Glynis Barber and Michael Brandon. Good morning, guys.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Listen, thanks for coming in, by the way. Thanks for coming in. What a thrill to meet you. We're going to be talking about the reason for this visit in a minute, but just before we do that, can I say how impressed I was when I had a quick look on the internet last night of all the previous work, the body of work between the two of you that you've done. It's just been so many top shows. Do you now officially qualify as legends then?
Well, maybe here.
or surely you're too young to be the legendary status just yet, am I right?
Well,
you know, when you think about it, okay, so I've been doing this for 45 years. That's what
he's old enough to be a legend. Yeah. I'm way too young.
Okay, well, listen, you both look fantastic. I don't know what your secret is, but I think you in particular could probably tell us how we can stay youthful. And I noticed something last night. You've got something going on with that.
Well,
you?
I have, yes. Well, yes, I did. I launched an anti-aging lifestyle website, and because it is sort of my hobby. I'm really into sort of exercise and healthy living. I am genuinely interested in it, and you know, who wants to get old and sickly? I don't want to. I want to stay fit and healthy. So I did that, and I'm having great fun with it. And I also released a yoga DVD as well.
Well, you're both living proof that it works.
Well, I'm telling you, she's living proof. I look at her. She actually looks great. I actually, you know, find myself going, "You look great." You know,
it's amazing. So
I think they both look great. I mean,
thanks.
For the Beckhams, never heard of them. Look at this. This is a celebrity couple of the year, as far as I'm concerned. Anyway, listen, we can't get you into the radio station and not talk about Dempsey Makepeace. What a smash hit show that was. And it's still as popular now as it ever was. Can you believe that it would still be talked about all these years later?
It is amazing. I mean, I don't know. How long ago is it now?
Well, it's coming up to 30 years, isn't it?
Wow.
So just under 30 years ago. And it is amazing because people presumed it went on for ages. And we actually only did 3 series of 10 episodes. So we actually only ever made 30 episodes,
31.
Which isn't that much. 31.
31. The first one was a two-parter.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. But it was an amazing show. It's how we met. And the people just took to it, you know, and they had to create an exporting department for it. You know, it was in 75 countries, and it was a good show. I really enjoyed it, and I have really fond memories of the show and everybody who worked on it.
Does it sort of irk you a little bit? Now, it was hugely successful, so I'm not suggesting that you would be playing it down in any way, but does it get a bit irksome sometimes that that's what people remember most about you guys? Because you've done so much, but it always comes back to that. Do you always think, oh, not that question again?
Well, I think that happens to most actors, because there's going to be something that's going to sort of make you famous, that's going to make its mark, people know you for, and that's what they're going to remember you for. And it's nice to be remembered for something than not to be remembered at all, so no.
But keep it moving, you know. It's good. You can't forget what put you there, what made you in the focus,
yeah,
you know. So
course,
you have respect for that, but you move along, and then there are the other projects just come, and you know. But they always do come back. There's rarely a talk show we do on TV that doesn't start with a clip. You know.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. I mean, why do you think people loved it so much? I mean, I know why I watched it. I mean, I watched it because you were in it. Sorry, Michael. But I'm sure the ladies watched it because you were in it. But
well,
you're right, it only ran for, what, 30 episodes? Did it run about then, did you say?
Yeah, it was only 30 episodes, which is really not very many. But I think people were into the relationship. You know, it was that will they, won't they thing. It's a winning formula. If you look at all, you know, many series that have been popular have been based on that formula. So I think it was the chemistry.
Do you wish it had went on longer, Michael, or were you quite happy with that run?
I actually was happy for it to go on. I wanted it to go on because I was directing in the third year, and I was really enjoying that as well, with a bit of writing, and it was just all around great fun. And we were like a family by then, you know. We became like an attack unit, you know. We were all tight. We all had great respect for each other, and we were having a really good time. I think that if it had gone on for another year or two, it would have been syndicated across the world in a better way also. But you know, it was a different time then.
I mean, I think if a series like that came up now, there's no doubt it would have lasted longer. But in those days, it was
when would they cancel a series with 20 million viewers? You know, it wouldn't happen.
That actually leads me nicely to the next thing I was going to ask you guys. I mean, the worldwide recession's had an impact on all businesses across the globe. Has it had an effect on the acting profession? Is there less work out there, do you think?
Yeah, I mean, actually, actors are often the first people to get hit, really, because, you know, it affects salary and wages and the amount of work. I mean, you know, the amount of reality TV is much huger now. So after the boom of the 80s, I mean, it began in the 90s, really, and no, it hasn't helped at all.
I know when I've been watching a lot of dramas recently, it kind of seems to be the same faces that are coming up again and again.
Yeah.
You know, and I wonder why these people get in the work. And why is it necessary? I think last week I watched Broadchurch and a few other things, and you know, and the guy that was in that was in something else I was watching, and I thought, why are these? There's going to be loads of people looking for work.
It
I mean,
is
why
true,
is that?
Isn't it? You do yeah. tend to see the same
few
group
people
of faces
over and over
on television
yeah.
All the time, and you know, there.
It's
there
playing
so,
it safe. Is
there
what
are so
it
many
is.
Great
Somebody's
actors
successful
out there.
In something, put them in this, that'll make it successful
right.
as well.
Yeah.
Right. But let's
yeah.
talk love letters.
Yeah, that's why you're here. That's why they're here, everybody. They're at the Dundee Rep all this week with love letters. Tell us about it in your own words. What's it all about? I mean, it's been running for quite a long time with various different people doing it. Am I right?
This is our first time, and in fact, this is our first time on stage together ever.
Really?
In the history of the world. So we've never done a play together, and we've talked about it, and you know, over the years, and it just didn't happen for whatever reason. So you know, this week just sort of popped in and sort of came up quite nicely. It's just the two of us on stage. It's a love affair between two people through letters.
Over 30 years.
Over a very long time. And I know that sounds, you think, people reading love letters, how boring is that? But it's an incredibly moving piece. I mean, every time we do it, I feel so moved. And you know, there's a great reaction to it. People are quite tearful.
If you're listening to the radio at the moment thinking, oh, do I fancy that? Do I not? Well, it's a Pulitzer Prize play. And I know there's been a lot of people that have done it before you. I mean, I was looking at the list of people. Goodness me, it goes on forever. Kathleen Turner's on the list. Mel Gibson, George Segal. All these people have done it. Sigourney Weaver, Jerry Hall. David Soul. Does that put you under any pressure knowing all these people have performed?
Well, I didn't know that, so thank you
Is
very much.
Is that something
much.
You've learned today?
No, I didn't know that, and really it doesn't matter.
We're Sorry, have I spoiled it.
Nobody's seen us do it. And, you know, it's like, it works. That's the reason all those people do it, because it works. And people enjoy it. And I think that's what's going to happen.
I do remember when we were living in America, we were living in Los Angeles in the 1990s, and I never went to see it, funnily enough, but I do remember it being on with Robert Wagner and, you know, I can't remember who else, but they were amazing names. And I think it's because it's one of those gigs, you know, you are reading, so you don't have to learn the line. So it's very easy to get people like that in, you know, for a shorter while to come in. So I think it's... And it's very well written.
I was just going to say that. I've not seen it, so I'm relying on you to keep me right with that. But it sounds like it has to be good narrative to carry it off.
It is. It is. And as I said, it's really sort of strangely moving how involved you get. You know, they go, you know, a large expanse of time. So from quite a young age to sort of the present day, and you see them through the course of their lives through these letters, and it's absolutely fascinating.
What's amazing is how come this has never been a radio show?
Do you know? Well, maybe it has.
That's a good point, actually.
Do you know it would make a great radio show?
Great radio
as well.
Show. It would okay. be brilliant radio. There you go.
I'm writing it down. You heard it here first. So listen, I can't believe it's the first time you've both been working together on a project. I mean,
no, on stage.
Oh,
We have filmed. We haven't filmed together that much since Dempsey Makepeace, but we have done a few projects together. But
right.
No, this is the first play we've ever done.
Well, I was going to ask if that's an advantage or a disadvantage. Which one of you would like to answer that?
What, working together?
Working together, yeah.
Well, it can go either way, actually.
Yeah, it could. You know, I mean, you know, when she starts doing her little vocal exercises this morning, I'm going, what is that? You know, and, you know, because that's never happened before, but that's what she does in the theater, you know. You know, we have our different ways of working also, and here we are doing it together. So
as a married couple, if one of you happens to get a line wrong, does the other one remind that person, or would you just...
Yeah,
gloss
yeah.
over that.
I get reminded more, I think.
Ain't going to happen anyway, because you're so good at what you do. And as I say, we're really looking forward to this. Welcome to Dundee. It's brilliant to see you here. Do you get a chance to visit Scotland very much, guys?
Not very much, but I do have the Scottish roots. I was born in South Africa, but my grandfather was born in Edinburgh. And I have another, I think it was my great-grandfather was born in Glasgow. So, my mother's maiden name was Rob. So I am actually half Scottish.
And I used to do the Scottish voices for Thomas the Tank for America, which cracked up the crew pretty much.
I did
a mini series in the Borderlands.
The Borders.
I was there for several weeks filming a couple of years ago. It was a Rosamund Pilcher book, and Charles Dance and Eileen Atkins, and a wonderful cast, and we had a great time, and it was so beautiful.
I always come to Scotland when I'm doing a play. I've played Edinburgh, Aberdeen and Glasgow several times. So that's been nice.
Well, this is the home of Brian Cox. He's our most famous son in the acting world.
Yes.
And he's been at the Rep a few times.
Yes.
And I also thought, since you were in Dundee today, I would... Well, Dundee is famous for jam, jutes and journalism. I don't know if you know that or not, but you do now. And I thought, I'll give you a little gift to remind you of coming to Wave 102 and Dundee, because this covers everything to do with the city.
Oh.
So for the jutes, there's a little bag with your woolly on it for you right there.
Oh.
And I thought, you know, the journalism
what
thing,
is a jute?
Jute? What's a jute?
It's
what?
Like Hessian. It's like the material. Dundee's famous for it.
Oh, jute. Right, jute. Right. I have a jute rug, yes.
There you go. Well, that's a jute.
Ah, right, okay.
And we're famous for marmalade, so I thought I'd get you some of our traditional Dundee marmalade.
Oh, lovely.
There you go.
Thank you.
A little bit of jam. Now you can spread
fantastic.
That on your toast, guys.
There's breakfast.
You can take it home tonight to the hotel room and smear it over yourself.
What flavour you got?
Strawberry.
But I'm sure that you'll love it anyway. And as I say, a little memento coming into Dundee. It's brilliant. So just before we go over love letters again, what's happening in the future then? There's some exciting projects coming up, isn't there?
Well, I go into episode series 3 with Matt LeBlanc. That'll be next. We do that in London and towards the end of the month. I was in series 2 and now series 3, and then could be Mr. Selfridge again, which, you know,
brilliant,
they're doing
Matt.
Series
brilliant.
3, 2 now.
Brilliant.
I've got, I think I've got an episode of Law & Order coming out sometime soon, either May or June, and I did a Miss Marple, but I don't know when that'll be out. And also quite soon coming out a pilot for a new sitcom on BBC Three called Bamboo. So look out for that. It's quite
brilliant.
Naughty and quite funny, and I'm looking forward to that.
Sounds like my kind of thing. Anyway, listen, a pleasure to meet you face to face. Thanks for coming into Wave 102, and love letters at the Dundee Rep for all of this week. Don't miss it. It's a must-see, and let us know what you think about that.
When are you coming, Dave? When are you coming?
I'll be there, my friend. Probably Friday will suit me better. We'll wait till the end, and then we can have a big bash there. But listen, it's fabulous, honestly. I know I'm paid to say that, but honestly, it is going to be great, and these are great professionals. So please go along to Dundee Rep and give it your support. Ladies and gentlemen, Glynis Barber and Michael Brandon, what a real thrill. Thanks for coming in, guys.
Thank you, Dave.
Thank you, Dundee.
See you the next time you're here. See ya.